The first song we will be singing is called Hark, I Hear the Harps Eternal, and it was arranged by Alice Parker. And there's probably not another piece that we sing that expresses such joy and happiness. So at the beginning, I commend you to actually close your eyes and listen to it as you hear an army approaching. It sounds almost like a march, and you'll just get the gist of it. And once it gets into the joyful parts, you'll be able to feel it. And with your eyes closed, I think you'll experience what all the lyrics has to offer and all the musical, you know, intonation that's inside of it. So here goes, Harks, I Hear the Harps Eternal.
Hark, I hear the harps eternal ringing on the farther shore. As I near those swollen waters with their deep and solemn roar, Alleluia, 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 praise the Lamb, Alleluia, Alleluia, glory to the great I Am. And my soul shall sing with sorrow, fading as the light of day, passes swiftly o'er those waters to the city far away.
Next piece is Flower of Beauty, and it was composed by John Clements. And after listening to this piece for numerous times, I've come to realize what it's actually really about. It's just about a man describing the one he loves and how they're going to be together someday. The song is just beautiful, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Neighbor.
next selection of tonight is The Water Is Wide, arranged by Richard Smith. As many of us have experienced young love, and this song manages to capture the joy and the tragedy that it can bring.
Our next selection is Set Me as a Seal by Renee Clausen. When Renee wrote this piece, she had written it as a spouse or a significant other to the other person, saying, I will always love you, and you can trust this as a seal, like a seal you would put on an envelope. But as many songs are, they mean different things to different people. Two schools here, including my own, have lost someone in this program that's very dear for us, and two people that have also been here the past year, Nicholas Holliday and Daryl Miller.
Right?
Yes. Daryl Miller. And to us, it means that, I'm sorry, it means that that those people have left something with us and have sealed us with their eternal watch and their eternal grace. And I just hope that it really means something to you as well. But,
yeah.
Set me as
final piece we're performing tonight is Walking Down That Glory Road, composed by Mr. Mark Hayes. The song spoke to me the most, and I hope it really does speak to you. It's about how everybody has obstacles in their life, whether it be in the past or the present, that they've had to get over, or still have to. And it's important that in our struggle in the present, that we keep our head focused towards the future and leave what happened in the past. So I hope you enjoy this song.